Hello guys, welcome to Python Full Stack Course. In this training video, we will start with getting started with Python. We will cover creating variable and assigning values, user input, built-in model and function, and then we'll discuss the help utility. Here myself, Professor Gopal Patil. Welcome to our YouTube channel. If you first time visit the channel, then do subscribe and push the notification bell on so that all the notification related to Python will reach to you. Let us start with the Python. First verify that the Python is installed or not. So first we'll check whether the Python is installed in the system or not. So go to your terminal and type python space --url so that it will show you which version we are using for a Python. So I am using Python 3.7. There are two major versions of Python are currently active. There are 2x and 3x. 3x is the current version and it's under active development. Now I have to print a certain statement in the Python. Then we have to start the Python. Just use the Python command so that the Python prompt will start and we can type the command. So first I'll type the print command and print a certain message. Let's say welcome to Python Full Stack course. Python full stack course and just press enter so that particular message is going to print. So it means that the Python is installed and it works properly in the system. The same thing we can do in Anaconda Python distribution, which contains spider ID for Python implementation. So let us start the same thing with the spider ID. In the spider ID, we have to start the Anaconda distribution in that. There are many IDs are available. Out of that, we are using spider ID for this full stack course. So I just open the spider ID, which contains spider editor, IPython console, and variable. So first of all, I just save the file with name, let's say test, and that file I save on the desktop. So just click on save. So that file is saved with the test name. The same thing that I just write the command print and type the same message, that is welcome to Python full stack course, and just type this enter. Now we want to execute this command, just select that line and either press F5 or click on the run tab so that particular command is going to execute. There is another way that instead of executing on the editor, we just copied this command or statement from editor and paste it in the IPython console. Press enter. The same thing is going to happen. So either we can run on terminal in a Viper or we can use a spider ID. And that again, two ways are there. One is either I am using spider ID or I am using IPython console. So in this way, we can start by using a simple command in a Python. The next important thing is creating and assigning values to the variable. So when we assign the value to the variable, the specific way to assign the variable in a Python, that is variable name is equal to value. The Python uses equal to sign to assign the values to the variable. There is no need to declare a variable in advance. Whenever there is a requirement of variable, we can use it or declare it. Here I'll give some example. Let's say we'll write a variable a is equal to 2. Now value 2 is stored inside a variable a. I just compile this code so that the particular line is executed and value of a is stored. In the variable explorer, I'll find that name is a and the value is stored as a 2. If I want to print that value in the console, then we can just write the command print a so that it will print the particular value of the variable a. So a is going to be print, that is 2. As good as we can store a large value, let's say p is equal to, let's say mobile number or a certain large value, we can print that value. Similarly, that we print a, just like compile this particular code so that b is what we print. So large value also store in terms of integer. That will see that how the data type is being used. Next is that if you want to store a float value inside a variable, let's say pi is equal to 3.14, then I'll just print that pi and confirm that the outcome is there 3.14 as good as the data type is float. So according to the requirement, Python compiler will take the data type. Next is, let's say I use one more variable is name, and I just write name is Google Party, and I just print that name so that the name is going to be printed and the data type is a string. Even though there is no need to specify data type when declaring a variable in Python, while allocating the necessary area in a memory for the variable, the Python interpreter automatically picks the most suitable built-in data type for the variable. When we create a variable, there are certain rules we have to follow. The first rule is that the variable name must start with a letter or an underscore. It cannot be start with the numbers or a symbol. As well as the data type should be a case sensitive. So Python is a case sensitive language, so we have to follow that rule of Python. Suppose now I want to check the data type of the variable. Here in the variable explorer, it is already been there which data type of variable is created. Suppose I want to check here, so what I'll do, I here write print type of variable A, and just I execute one more time this particular code so that it will print it is a type of integer. So first it is a declared variable A with value is 2, then it print the type is integer, and then it print its value that is 2. So in this way you can create a variable and assign the values to the variable. The next thing is user input. Up to this point what we have discussed, we just assign the value to the variable, but we are not reading the input from the user. You can read the input from the user by using input method. So let's say I write name is equal to input and just write the message, what is your name, and then I'll print the name. So when I write the input function, so input will be taken from the user and the message is going to be printed. So let's say I just compile this first line only so that the function is executed and it will ask for what is your name. And when you execute this line, there is a square red symbol here. It means that IPython console is running. I have to type the name of the person that you want to enter. So let's say Google, and that name has been entered in the system. So when I print the name, that name is going to be printed. Instead of the input number complex, but it's very important to understand that when you enter the numbers, so we read as a string and we have to convert the string into integer. So here I'll take an example, x is equal to input. Enter the number, so that number will be read from the user. Then we can convert that number into integer. Say here I write y equal to, and I'm going to that string into integer, so I write integer x by 2. So that the resultant value will be stored to 1, and then I'll print the value of 1. Now we'll see how it works. So just I compile this code. Once I compile, I am going to enter the number. So let's say I enter number 7 from user, and then I'll enter. So it will perform the 7 by 2, that is 3.5, and it will print the answer 3.5. You can also check the data type of the device flow. It automatically takes the compiler when we execute the command. This is all about the user input. Next important thing is that built-in models. Module is a file containing definition and a string. And a function is a piece of code which executes some logic. Now I will write a statement print. And it is one of the functions under the modern man, that is power. And this is 2.3. So 2:3 I have to find out. So this is the modern man which contains the function power that I use. So you can just import the model first, import man. So it means that the particular model is imported in the program, and then you can use that model function within the program. So I just compile this. So 2.1 and 2:3 is the template. If you want to check the inbuilt directories under these modules, so you can use a directory here as a function. And then we have to pass a parameter __ built-in. And again __. If I execute this command, then you will find all the methods which is inbuilt are with this. The next important thing is the detail about the help functionality. So whenever I want to find any inbuilt function parameters or use, we can just enter help and name of the function. Suppose I want to check the max function use from the box, and then I just compile it so that it will print all the details about the max function. So this is the way that we can just start with the Python. Hope you like this video. If you like this video, kindly subscribe the channel. Thank you.